Today's playthrough is Assassin's Creed 3.
Used to be when people talked about the end of the world, we locked them up. Or laughed them off. Sometimes both. But we never took them seriously. Maybe we should have. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Better to start at the beginning, with the abduction of Desmond Miles, my son. This boy had no ambition, no direction, no plans for the future. What he did have was a heritage, one he chose to deny. It nearly cost him his life. He was captured and imprisoned. Those who took him believed he could help them find something. The apple. One of several artifacts we call pieces of Eden. Bits of ancient technology scattered across the globe. Some hidden, some found, all of them dangerous. Most are held by a single group, the same group that now had Desmond. You know them as Abstergo Industries. We know them as the Templars. As the enemy. We've been fighting them for thousands of years. Even longer if you believe the stories of their origins. I do. After all, I've seen the truth. That's the beauty and the horror of the Animus. A device that allows us to enter and experience the lives of our ancestors. It holds the power to change everything, to show us history the way it really happened. Up until its creation, to the victor when the spoils, when the truth. We're trying to fix that, to free minds and bodies both. But there's only so much that we can do, and the Templars have the upper hand these days. But something larger than the Assassins and Templars is approaching, bigger than all of us. And if we can't find a way to stop it, these next few weeks will probably be our last. Everyone's last. In the end, it all comes down to him. To Desmond. Through the Animus, he discovered his heritage, explored the lives of his ancestors, and uncovered their secrets. When that was done, he trained. He used another ancestor to provide decades of experience in the span of a few days. It worked. We think. We hope. Soon, though, soon we'll know. ominous date fast approaches, December 21st, 2012. None of us knows what it'll bring, only that this is where they want us to be when it does. They've been guiding us in their own fractured, frustrating way. These voices from the first civilization, the ones who came before, a precursor race of immense power and uncertain motives. They're the ones who made the pieces of Eden. This is where they've led him, and through him, us. He stands at the entrance to this long-lost place, armed with the knowledge of Altair and the abilities of Ezio. He holds in his hands the apple of Eden, and we stand at his side, ready to support him however we can. His name is Desmond Miles, and he has brought us to the end.
Good story.
We're here.
Creepy looking cave.
Let's go.
Punk ass kids doing graffiti. Boom! What the smig is the apple doing here? A little slot there.
In another moment, down went Alice after it. Never once considering how in the world she was to get out again.
Dirty old cave.
I think we're here.
Oh, yeah, shit. Hey. That's a steep one. Yo, stairs covered up by earth. Writing and some more writing. Thank you. blackout.
Desmond?
Do you hear us?
Yeah. What happened?
The temple triggered a bleeding effect. You collapsed and entered into a fugue state.
So naturally, you dropped me into the Animus instead of, I don't know, making sure I was okay?
Excuse me for a moment. My Xbox is not a very nice little bugger.
You weren't in any danger. Besides, the temple appeared to be communicating with you. And I didn't want to risk severing the connection. At least not until we knew what it wanted.
Right. Of course.
Son, I...
No, it's fine. I get it. And I know what I'm looking for, by the way. It's a key. Just no idea where it is, though. I guess that's why she triggered the bleeding effect.
She?
Juno, Dad. She's talking to me.
Okay, Desmond. While you were, visiting Constantinople, we picked up a software update for the Animus. I'd like to run a couple of quick tests, make sure there aren't any major issues.
All right. What do you need me to do?
We'll start simple. Walk to the marker over there.
There we go. There we go. They're a lot more agile.
Okay, Desmond. Let's practice climbing on these objects. That's a constraint. These are optional objectives that raise your synchronization rate. All right, Desmond, follow the on-screen instructions and kill the two Templars. All you have to do here is jump the gap.
Whoa. Okay. Why are you always so used to holding the A button? Do you know I make some sort of a change to that sort of feature?
Synchronization levels are good now. We should be able to build the world. Time to find out what the temple wants.
Thank you. Sir.
Everything all right, sir?
Yes, fine. I'm just preoccupied, that's all.
Don't forget your invitation. Master Birch will be meeting you inside.
Thank you.
Where shall I retrieve you once you're done?
Front of the Opera House. And be quick about it. Don't expect to be here long.
I'll bring her round at once.
Good animation.
Invitation, please. Shall I take your coat, sir?
Gentlemen, you are requested to kindly find your seats.
Something odd about these American sheep. Last I've heard, they were staging another war by
Empire. Very gosh.
Good evening, sir. This way, please.
Cheers. Please. Sorry, that.
My apologies.
Yeah, sorry about that, mate. Do pardon me. Excuse me now. Thank you.
Evening, Hatham.
Reginald?
I can't tell you how happy I was to hear they'd mounted this revival. Gay's best work by far. Have you seen it before?
Once. My father brought me here as a child. Though I remember little of it. I don't suppose tonight will afford me the luxury of a proper viewing either.
No, I'm afraid it won't. On to business then. Do you see him?
And a statesman because he's so great thinks his trade as honest as mine. A lawyer is an honest employment, so is mine. Like me too.
He's seated in one of the boxes above.
The stairs are watched. We need to find another way up.
It is but fitting that we should protect and encourage cheats.
That mall at set word of trial comes on in the afternoon, and she hopes he will order matters so as to bring her on.
This is very active
and industrial.
Let's not delay.
We may satisfy her that I'll soften the evidence.
£1,000.
My
apologies.
Oh, lazy dog. When I took him the time before, mate. I told him what would come to if he did not bend his hand. This is death. Mention a bucket. Poor Tom Gag. £40. Let Betty Sly know I'll save her from transportation. So I can get more of my estate in.
Betty has brought more goods into our lot for years than any private gang. And in truth, it is a pity to lose so good a customer.
Get the room, you two.
She might be in the common course of business. Leave her 12 months longer. I loved her that way, but expect a good sportsman always lets the end of our critter's blood was to breathe the game depends on. Besides, here the law allows us no reward. There's nothing to be got by the death of women, except our wives.
Without dispute, she is a fine woman. It was to her I was obliged for my education. And to say a bold word, she hath trained up more young fellows to the...
Pick lock. Steady.
Oh, there's a killer about. I'm staying where it's safe.
Nobody wants to stay where there's a killer about them, right?
No! No! Be sure there is no danger!
Excuse me, that old boy.
Who are you?
So far, so good.
I'll take you on here. You search down there. Very well. If you find anyone, give a shout.
And how was the opera?
Rather dull, truth be told.
Shall we be off then?
Aye. To Fleet and Bride.
By your command.
Well, where are we now?
Gentlemen, I hold in my hand a key. If this book is to be believed, it will open the doors of a storehouse built by those who came before.
Ah, yes. Those who ruled, reigned, and vanished from the world. Do we know what it is that will be held within?
It could contain certain knowledge, perhaps a weapon, or something as yet unknown, unfathomable in its construction and purpose. It could be any of these things, or none of them. They are still an enigma, these precursors. But of one thing I am certain. Whatever waits behind those doors shall prove a great boon to us all.
Or our enemies, should they find it first.
They won't. You've seen to that.
I assume you know where this storehouse is.
Ah, Mr. Harrison.
Gentlemen.
How fair your calculations?
I believe the site lies somewhere within this region.
That's a lot of ground to cover.
My apologies. Were that I could be more accurate.
That's all right. It suffices for a start. And that is why we've called you here, Master Kenway. We'd like for you to travel to America, locate the storehouse, and take possession of its contents.
I'm yours to command. Although a job of this magnitude will require more than just myself.
Of course. Upon this paper are the names of 5 men sympathetic to our cause. Each is also uniquely suited to aid you in your endeavor. With them at your side, we'll want for nothing.
Well, then I'd best be on my way.
I knew our faith in you was not misplaced. We booked you passage to Boston. Your ship leaves at dawn. Go forth, Haytham, and bring honor to us all.